Hi, I'm Andy Carter and I live near Nottingham, and this is my collection of Peel microcars. As you can see, they are extremely small and I love them because they are so unusual. This is a Peel P50 and it was built in Peel, Isle of Man in 1963. It is missing the normal things you see on a normal car, such as a speedometer, an indicator, any brake lights. Well, unfortunately, without indicators, you have to use hand signals. This window doesn't open, so all I'm able to do is put my arm out the window and signal a right turn, a left turn, or a slowing down, and that is all I can do.
Hello, I'm Grant Kearney, and I'm the owner of this 1965 Peel Trident. It was designed to be able to carry two people undercover for short distances, mainly in the city. The advantage was cheap tax, economical, almost 100 miles to the gallon, and a very low purchase price of £189, so ideal commuting transport.
That should do for a couple of hundred miles. It had a clear plexiglass dome, which was very easy and cheap to make, and it made it very interesting and very hot inside. Unfortunately, driving a Peel Trident is rather an experience. This is the only form of ventilation and space for hand signals. It has even less controls than the Peel P50, just a simple handbrake and pedals, and the gear change lever down here, and it was very, very, very scary to drive fast.
This particular vehicle has a top speed of around 40 miles an hour, which may seem dreadfully slow by today's standards, but when you're riding on 5-inch tyres, it's incredibly fast. Of course, the top speed is also altered by depending upon how big a lunch you had. The more you eat, the slower the car goes.
Both Peel P50 and Peel Tridents had the same 49cc DKW engine, which originally came from a DKW Hummel moped. Have a 4 horsepower at rating, 2 strokes, so you have to mix oil in with the petrol, and 3 forward speeds with no reverse whatsoever.
When new in 1965, the sales slogan used to describe this car was it was almost cheaper than walking. That might have been the case 45 years ago. However, if you were to offer me €40,000 today, the answer would sadly be no. And anyone who out there who would want one, I would highly recommend it. Start searching, persevere, as there are only ever 80 built. They're out there. Try, locate one, find one, own it, and enjoy it.